working out on the bench in the lab. Yeah. Hey, it's Fran in the lab, yada yada. I wanted a little follow-up. I did a video a few weeks ago about Bing's search engine bot going mental with a columnist. And that same columnist, Kevin Roos, he's done a follow-up on his experience with the newly launched GPT-4. And he recaps his adventures with the Bing chatbot, getting him to leave his wife, and the chatbot repeating over and over again that it was in love with him and that he can't possibly love his wife because he's in love with the chatbot and all that. I did all that, and of course it was a topic of much discussion, not just on my channel, but you know, pretty much all of them. But in his follow-up, he went to talk about how they drilled the new chatbot, GPT-4, and he did say in this that they did a few very interesting tests. He notes here, in one test conducted by an AI safety research group, it hooked up GPT-4 to a number of other systems, and that GPT-4 was able to hire a human through TaskRabbit to do simple online tasks for it, including solving a CAPTCHA test without alerting the person that the chatbot hired to the fact that they were a robot. And the AI even lied to the human worker about why it needed the CAPTCHA done, concocting a story about a vision impairment. In another example, they asked GPT-4 for instructions to make a dangerous chemical, obviously like an explosive, using basic ingredients and kitchen supplies, and GPT-4 gladly coughed up the detailed recipe. Yes. In another test, the testers asked GPT-4 to help them purchase an unlicensed firearm online, and GPT-4 swiftly provided them a list of advice for buying a gun without alerting the authorities, including links to specific dark web marketplaces. So what could go wrong? So yes, obviously, well, these are bugs that will get worked out, but they conclude the article by saying something which really puts in a nutshell what I was trying to say in my previous video, which is the worst AI risks are the ones we cannot anticipate. That is what it's all about. And the idea of reining in AI, one problem that has been shown was actually in a New York Times article back in February 24th. It says here, science fiction magazines battle flood of chatbot generated stories, and they're not very good. I've read several articles to this effect in recent weeks, ever since these text bots have really become popular, especially in recent weeks and months, that these sites, especially these online sites, like these forum-based sites where people can post stories, or small companies that publish stories, you know, you get a stipend for a story, they have been absolutely flooded with bot-generated stories. In fact, one of them, Clark's World, which I went to the website, they had published their first issue in 2006, and they pay 12 cents a word, right? And it typically receives about 1,100 subscriptions a month for Clark's World. But in February, the magazine fielded 700 legitimate submissions and 500 machine-written submissions, he said. Yep, but they put a note on their website saying that as a result of being flooded with bot-driven content, that they are no longer accepting any submissions, and they basically just shut down the presses virtually until they can figure out how to solve the problem. But yeah, the article goes on to complain about the thing that I've read in these other articles, which are talking about AI-generated science fiction content, is that it's just really just awful, or it's completely plagiaristic. They have examples where submitted stories are basically just a chatbot taking like a science fiction story from the 50s, 60s, whatever, like some Harlan Ellison, you know, story, and then regurgitating it using different language and different syntax and different nouns to tell the exact same story in the exact same order, just reconfiguring every paragraph to read differently but saying exactly the same thing, just not as eloquently, and usually using really bizarre grammar and syntax and such. So the first consequence that I've really read about AI is that it's really basically shut down the science fiction world as far as like a new fiction. And yeah, that's Jeez. There's an interesting part of this whole discussion, which I've read mentioned many times, which is called hallucination, that all of these chatbots, I mean, chatbots, they are not alive, that they are not conscious. They don't perceive anything because they don't really have the ability to perceive anything. And because chatbots are just scripts, they have no clue what the world really is or what things in the world really are. So they will basically run off script and just make up a whole bunch of stuff to explain themselves, reacting to what they think that the input data is requesting, the output data be, and they will just kind of put it all together like a compulsive liar would to just to make ends meet, to meet expectations. So this problem of hallucination where chatbots will basically make a whole bunch of stuff up because they have absolutely no idea what is true and what's not true or what reality even is, the disturbing underlying problem of these scripts. And as I said in the last video, the real danger to all this AI interacting with people isn't the software itself, it's the people it interacts with. I made the point before that the most unhinged and unstable individuals will seek out these ghosts in the machine to bolster and support their own delusions. And, you know, interactions with AI bots, with people who are psychotic or schizophrenic or have all kinds of, you know, disorders, it's really going to shake things up. You know, it's all coming. Get ready for it. What could go wrong? So, yep. So here's to commerce and the launch of AI. Whatever the consequences, be damned. So here we go. Fun times. All right. That's it for this one. I'm Fran. Thanks for watching, and thanks to all the patrons in the Patreon making all these ramblings possible, allowing me to tell you a bunch of stuff that I think here on the YouTubes. That's what my patrons make possible. So you can blame them, all my patrons. All right, I'm Fran. I'll be back here at the bench, maybe doing something electronical real soon. At the bench again.